Good morning, dear students. Today we will discuss about nanomaterials. So, what is nanomaterials? So, nanomaterials are the materials whose the principle the materials which are in a single unit or a small size molecules whose internal or external dimension is in between 1 to 100 nanometers. So, the molecules or atoms whose external or internal dimension is 10^-9 meter or 1 to 100 nanometers and is defined as a material with any of the external dimensions in the nanoscale or having internal structure or surface structure in the nanoscale. With the nanoscale defined as the length of the scale is a range approximately from 1 to 100 nanometers, and the internal dimension is in between 1 to 100 nanometers. The materials which is falling under the class of the size 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer is called as nanomaterials. The nanotechnology. So the nanotechnology is the assimilation or manipulation of the many of the such atoms. Either it is a single atom or maybe a cluster of atoms or maybe molecule or a mixture of atoms and molecules whose size is in between 1 to 100 nanometer, and assimilating such atoms and to make a material is the nanotechnology. And once the material is being made with the structure is in between 1 to 100 nanometer in one dimension, either of the length or the breadth or the height, and it involves the modifying the the characteristics properties, that is physical and chemical properties of such materials, and making into the form of a device. And the entire the technology is called as a nanotechnology. And these nanotechnology, because why these nanotechnologies is very essential. So the nanotechnology comes into force because of the properties of nanomaterials. So what are the properties of the nanomaterials? Physical and chemical properties of nanomaterials are significantly different from single atom or a bulk molecule. So when you consider a single atom or a bulk molecule, the physical and chemical properties are restricted. But in the nanomaterials, these properties are not restricted due to the first is the spatial confinement of atoms and molecules. So the atoms and molecules, when you reduce into one nanometer, that is 1 to 100 nanometer, the arrangement of atoms or molecules in the space, that is the spatial confinement, is not ordered. It is completely disordered arrangement. Because of such a disordered arrangement, what will happen? The energies of the orbitals are not fixed here. So the different orbital configurations you have studied in the bulk molecules, so those orbital configurations are not fixed. So energy contained in the orbital is also not fixed. So energies are not fixed, and the atoms and the molecules are randomly oriented in different space, in different forms. And electronic structure is also different. So different electrons, as you know, from the bulk materials, s electrons, p electrons, d electrons will have different energies in their orbitals. But here the electronic structure is entirely different. So electronic structure is not fixed here. Electronic structure will be continuously different. So electronic structure will change. Because of the change in the electronic structure, properties of the nanomaterials will also change. And because of the change in the electronic structure, chemical reactivity will also change. So due to a change in the chemical reactivity and a change in the improved optical, mechanical, biological or catalytic activity. So the very improved optical, mechanical or biological or catalytic activity enhances when you reduce the materials into nano form. So these nanoscale materials, why is in the small scale? So when you look into this figure, so the nanoscale is a very very, very tiny molecules, so whose internal or external dimension is in between 1 to 100 nanometer. So look at the different items here, the water, glucose, and antibodies, virus, bacteria, cancer cells, and in tennis balls. When you compare the external dimension of the different items here, the nanomaterials will fall in between 1 to 100 scale is a very, very small one. So the nano, you can see DNA which is having around 2.5 nanometer in diameter. Bacteria is in 2.5 micrometer long. When you consider a large raindrop, it would be in 2.5 millimeter in diameter. So nanoparticles in the cubic shape is in between 4 nanometers. The ions will have a 4 millimeter long. And this is the simplest comparison of the structure of the nano. So the structure of the nano will be very, very small as compared to the different items visible. So when you look into a single walled carbon nanotube, say a single walled carbon nanotube is whose the internal diameter is 1 nanometer in 1 nanometer. So it is when the carbon in the form of a graphene is rolled into the form of a cylinder, so the internal diameter will becomes 1 nanometer. So the strand of the hair, so it will become 100 micrometer in diameter. So very, very small diameter of the carbon nanotubes can enhance different properties. So when you compare with the human hair, so you can see the scanning electron microscopic images of the human hair. So when you look into the human hair, you can see human hair is very, very big as compared to the nanofibers, and the it is around 25,000 times nanometer wide, very, very wide, so you can fit many of the nanofibers into human hair. So the nanofibers typically is very, very small as compared to the human hair. You can see from the figure very clearly that nanofibers is very, very small. Now, when you look into the history, the first ever concept was presented in 1959 by the famous professor of the physics, Dr. Richard P. Feynman, and invention of the scanning tunneling microscope in 1981, and the discovery of the fullerene he has done in 1985, which has led to the emergence of nanotechnology. And this the term nanotechnology had been coined by Norio Taniguchi in 1974. So there is a lot of plenty of room at the bottom. Nanomaterials have superior properties than the bulk materials. So nanomaterials will have a superior properties. The properties which include the nanomaterials is the mechanical strength. Mechanical strength is the improved hardness, toughness of the metals, alloys, and maybe a toughness in the sense ductility, malleability, super plasticity of the ceramics. So when the material is reduced to nanoscale, and the mechanical properties will be improved hardness of the materials, and when you see into the catalytic activity, better catalytic efficiency through higher surface to volume ratio. So nanomaterials possesses a large surface area as compared to the volume of the material. So surface area is very, very higher, and the number of active centers are also higher. So the higher activity of the catalytic activity will be very, very higher. So higher surface to volume ratio of the materials takes place. So electrical conductivity, when you look into the electrical conductivity, increase the electrical conductivity in ceramics and the nanocomposites, increase the electrical resistance of the metals in case of nanomaterials. So the materials poses us increased electrical and electrical properties, because since the electronic structures will be entirely different when the bulk material is reduced to nanoscale. So spatial confinement of the electrons and the different orientation of the electrons makes different electrical conductivity. So the thermal stability, so enhanced thermal stability of the materials takes place. So, and magnetic properties increase the magnetic behavior of the materials. The magnetic behavior will be different as in the case of a bulk material. Magnetic properties are restricted to most of the classes, as in between paramagnetic and diamagnetic. Here you can see the mixture of paramagnetic as well as diamagnetic properties. So magnetic properties will be different at different temperatures. So optical properties in the sense the optical luminescence properties, either in the luminescence maybe in terms of a spectral shift of the absorption band, or maybe fluorescence, or maybe phosphorescence, or maybe a chemical reactions to emit a certain emission and absorption bands, that is also a chemical luminescence. So the entire optical properties, the absorbance of the radiation and emission of the radiation will be different for the different size of the nanoparticles. So size dependent properties is the very important criteria in case of nanomaterials. So the most of the nanomaterials possess the size dependent properties. Depending upon the different size, the properties will be different. Biologicals, you can see increased permeability through the biological membranes. So the permeability of the nanocellulose, for example, shows nanocellulose possesses a different permeability at different temperatures in different medium. So increases the biological So when you look into the bulk materials, you can see the most of the atoms or molecules which are situated in the bulk structure, cubic structure, is the most of the atoms inside the bulk. So that is why the material is called as a bulk material. So in the case of a nano, when you convert this bulk material into very smaller form, that is in the reduced form, 10^-9 meter form, so the number of atoms and the molecules over the surface considerably increases. So surface area increases, number of atoms or molecules present over the surface increases, and the active form of the atoms or molecules present over the surface is also increases, hence the catalytic properties will increases. So you will have a larger surface area which increases the catalytic activity. The properties of the materials can be different at different nanoscale for two main reasons. The first main reason is the nanomaterials have a relatively larger surface area, so surface area will be very, very larger as compared to the same mass of the materials produced from the bulk material. So as I explained, the surface area will become considerably higher. The higher surface area will lead to the more number of atoms or molecules to constitute on the surface. So you will have a larger surface area, as well as when the increase in the surface area takes place in the structure of the material, the number of atoms or molecules are also increases. And since the electronic structure is randomly oriented and its chemical reactivity at different temperatures is also different for different size of nanomaterials. So the nanoparticles can make materials for more chemically active. So chemical reactivity also increases. So the concept, the properties of the materials are different at the nanoscale because of these two main reasons. And not only to these reasons, add on reason is the quantum effects. Quantum effects is reaction or the emission or absorption of photons at the surface of the materials. So surface of the materials can absorb different photons at different temperature at different conditions, and emit certain photons at a different temperature and conditions. So the quantum effects begin to dominate, and the behavior of the matter, nanomaterials, is different as compared to the bulk. So the classification, nanoscale materials are classified as zero-dimensional materials where the length and the breadth and the heights are confined at a single point. So the example is nanodot, where the length, breadth and the heights are confined at a single point. such materials are called as zero dimensional material. Now the one dimensional material, the one dimensional material is one where the one of the parameter is fixed, either the length or the breadth or the height of the nanomaterial is fixed. So one parameter is either the length or the breadth or the height is fixed. Nanofibers, nanowires, nanorods, where the diameter of the rod is fixed, length of the rod is fixed, or maybe the height of the, you know, rod is fixed. Such materials are called as one-dimensional materials. Now into the two-dimensional materials, it has only the length and the breadth. Example, nanowires and nanotubes. Yeah, or maybe nanoplates. So the two-dimensional materials where length and the breadth is fixed usually. So such materials whose length may be, let us say, 15 nanometer, breadth may be around 50 nanometer. 15 into 50 nanometers, the such materials will come under the class of two-dimensional materials. So when you look into the three-dimensional materials has all parameters, let us say length, breadth and the height of the material is also fixed. So length of the material, breadth of the material as well as height of the materials are fixed in this case. So let us say the length is 50 nanometer, breadth is 10 nanometers and the height is 5 nanometers. So such materials are also exist, and such materials are called as three-dimensional materials. So the classification of nanomaterials in four different categories. First is zero-dimensional materials is confined to one single point, and one-dimensional materials where one of the parameter, length, breadth or the height of the material is fixed. Two-dimensional materials where length or the breadth, usually length and the breadth of the nanomaterials is fixed. And three-dimensionals, you have all parameters, length, breadth and the height of the nanoscale material. Now you can see A is the pictorial representation of the four different class of materials. The A is the nano dot or a quantum dot. B is nanowires or, you know, nanorods where diameter or the breadth is fixed. The C is the nanoplates where length and the breadth of the material is fixed. Variable. So D is the length, breadth and the height of the material is variable. In the cubic shape, you can have a length and the breadth and the height of the material. Thanking you.